Hi friends, I am Vishalakshi. In the previous lecture, we have seen different types of properties and at the same time specific gravity of solids and how to determine the specific gravity of solids with various methods. Okay, so in this video, I'll explain about the next property that is there with respect to soil. So it's nothing but density index. Okay, so this density index, we can also call it as relative density. Okay, so this relative density, according to this, it is named in the older terminology of soil. Okay, so the indication of this density index is nothing but ID, right? So this indicates the relative compactness of the soil mass, okay, and this is used in the relation to coarse grained soils or sands. Okay, so this relation is used in coarse grained soils or sands. So we have two forms of conditions. Okay, one is the loosest state of condition and another one is the densest state of condition. Okay, so in a dense condition the void ratio is low, whereas if you consider loose condition the void ratio is high. Okay, so why that is happening is because of the densification of the particles and the interaction of the particles which were there, right? So in this we'll place the void ratio and we'll determine and compare the void ratio in this relative density. Okay, so we'll see what is the conditions which are there with respect to this density index and how the grains are packed in the coarse grained soil. Okay, I'll show you the diagrams. What do you mean by the denseness with respect to void ratio with soil? Okay. So here I'm taking three cases. Okay, this portion is voids. Okay, we can take this as VV, that is volume of voids, and here we can take it as solids. So this we can designate with VS. So same likewise here also, voids. Here you can take VV and here this one is solid portion is solids BS. So this portion is solids. Okay, so in these three cases, we'll tell that what is the state of the condition of the sand. Okay, so in this condition, we can tell that this is the loosest state. Okay, so loosest state in the sense, we can say that the void ratio is maximum. Okay, so here when coming to this next case, so this is A, B and C. So when you come for this case, we can tell this as intermediate state. Okay, so here how will be the void ratio is intermediate, that is we can take it as E naught. Okay, and next condition, the third condition we can take is, this is VS, this one is the densest state. Okay, so here the void ratio is equal to E minimum. Okay, so I'll show you what do you mean by the loosest state of condition with respect to soil or sand and the densest state of condition with respect to soil. Okay, so when the soil particles are arranged in this manner, we can say that as loosest state. Okay, this condition is known as loosest state of soil. Okay, so in this aspect, here the void spaces are more. It's nothing but the void ratio is more in the condition of loosest state. And when coming to this densest condition, the particle interaction is more. Okay, so this condition we can tell as the densest condition, okay, or else you can tell it as compacted condition. So if you consider this densest state, the particles, the interaction or the interface of the particles are attached to each other, okay, so densification. So when compared to this loosest state, the void ratio in this densest state will be minimum, okay. So here it will be maximum. So finally we can say that when the soil is having voids more, then you can consider as a loosest state. Okay, and when you consider the void ratio is minimum, you can consider as densest state. So likewise here we have designated three aspects. One is where the loosest state you will be having void ratio in maximum condition, and when you come for this intermediate state, the void ratio will be E naught. Okay, it will be in equilibrium state with respect to the volume of solids, and when you come for the third condition, here densest state will be acquired. So if you acquire densest state, the void ratio will be minimum. Okay, so this is nothing but relative states of packing of a coarse grain soil. Okay, so here with these aspects, formulas have been given. Okay, so here the density index may be considered zero if the soil is in its loosest state. Okay, so how the density is considered is the density index is considered zero. When it is considered zero, if the soil is in loosest state. Okay, and when it is considered as unity, when the soil is considered as unity, then it is said that it is in densest state. Okay, so by this consistent of these two ideas, we will be getting the density index by the formula ID is equal to, it is represented by, density index is represented by ID. So the value is given by E max minus E naught divided by E max minus E minimum. Okay, so where we know that ID is equals to density index. Okay, E max is equal to, what do you mean by E? As we have seen the phase diagram, E is nothing but void ratio. Okay, so E maximum means maximum void ratio or void ratio in the loosest state. Okay, and next is E minimum. So what do you mean by E minimum is minimum void ratio or the void ratio in the densest state. Okay, so what do you mean by E naught? E naught is nothing but void ratio of the soil mass in the natural state okay so E naught is nothing but the void ratio of the soil mass in the natural state okay or else the condition and a question what it was given okay so E max and E minimum are referred as the limiting void ratios of the soil okay so E maximum and E minimum these are said that these are referred as the limiting void ratio of the soil okay so sometimes ID is expressed in percentages okay so this density index is expressed in percentages okay so by this equation we can write in the terms of dry unit weights okay so ID is equal to 1 by gamma minimum minus 1 by gamma naught okay so I'm giving these void ratios in conditions with respect to in terms of dry unit weight okay so as we all know gamma is nothing but dry unit weight okay so 1 by gamma minimum minus 1 by gamma naught divided by gamma max by gamma naught minimum sorry 1 by gamma max minus 1 by gamma minimum okay so we can write it as gamma max by gamma naught into gamma naught minus gamma minimum by gamma max minus gamma minimum okay so this is the form of density index with respect to the dry unit weight okay so E is equal to g gamma w by gamma d minus 1 okay so here from the three phase diagram gamma d is given by w s by v okay so we'll substitute this gamma d here e is equal to g gamma w by w s by v minus 1 okay so e is equal to v g gamma w by w s minus 1 okay so while finding this void ratio we should have a knowledge on specific gravity of soil okay so for the determination of the volume of soil sample may be a source of error in case of clay soils okay so with respect to clay soils we can't find the density index because they will be very small okay so this case have been acquired only in granular soils such as like sands okay so where this is available this concept of density index is applicable okay so we'll see that how the loose state of sand with respect to void ratio is taken right so assuming that sand in the loosest state okay so we can write it as E maximum is equal to VV max by VS minimum okay that is with respect to E max in loosest case so in this for which the corresponding value of density of index is taken as 0 okay so the density index is taken as 0. Okay, so that is with respect to loosest state condition. So we need to go for densest state also, right? So assuming the sand in densest state, okay, so E minimum is equal to volume of voids minimum condition to the volume of solids maximum condition, okay, so for which the density index is taken as unity. Okay, so here when the void ratio is maximum, the density index is taken as 0 in the loosest condition, and you come for the density state with respect to density index, the void ratio is taken as E minimum with respect to density index as unity. Okay, so we'll see that this density index by taking as a function of void ratio. Okay, so it can be easily understood with respect to this functional aspect, right? So here we can write it as ID is equal to function of void ratio. Okay, so depending upon this void ratio, we can tell the density index of the soil, whether it is in a loosest state condition or else like densest state condition. Okay, so we'll see graphically the relation between E and ID. Okay, so I'll show you the graph here. Okay, so here it is taken as E minimum. This is the intermediate state and this is the maximum condition. Okay, so on y axis density index is taken. Okay, on y axis density index is taken and on x axis void ratio is taken. Okay, so void ratio, it is represented with respect to E. Okay, so we can say that it is taken with respect to void ratio, and we can say that the curve is linear. Okay, so with respect to maximum condition, intermediate state and minimum condition, the density index is linear. Okay, so with this void ratio density, void ratio density index relationship, okay, so we'll see the void ratio relationship. So from this we can say that the relationship is with respect to the density index to the function of void ratio. Okay, so we'll take the limits respect to density index and void ratio. So void ratio is taken in these three conditions. One is the minimum condition, the intermediate condition and the maximum condition. And when coming to this density index, the limits are taken from 0 to 1. Okay, so as we have discussed here, the density index is 0 with respect to the loosest state, and density index as unity when it is in the form of densest state. Okay, so ID is equal to function of E. So this density index limits what we are taking here is from 0 to unity, that is 0 to 1. So you can take it as 1 minus 0. Okay, and here with respect to this void ratio, we have three conditions, that is minimum condition, intermediate condition and maximum condition. Okay, so we'll take here E maximum minus E minimum. Okay, so from this we can take, it can be seen that from tan theta is equal to, okay, so before going to that trigonometric relations, sin theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse, okay, cos theta is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse, and tan theta is nothing but opposite by adjacent. Okay, so here the angle is, so you can take this as opposite side and this is adjacent side and the longest side is hypotenuse. Okay, so from here theta, okay, so the theta is here, so that is why the opposite state is, condition is opposite and this one is adjacent and the longest state hypotenuse. Okay, so tan theta is equal to I naught id by e naught. Okay, so with respect to density index and with respect to the value of e naught, so here we are telling that id is nothing but unity. Okay, so unity in the sense 1. So e naught we are taking the limitations here. Why I have taken id is equal to 1 is from condition is 0 to 1, so 1 minus 0 obviously it is 1. Okay, so 1 divided by e naught, the condition is from the minimum state to maximum state void ratio. Okay, so that is nothing but e maximum minus e minimum. Okay, so here therefore we can write it as, so for intermediate value e naught, okay, so from the condition the density index we have a formula as e maximum minus e naught by e maximum minus e minimum. Okay, so from that we can write it as e maximum minus e naught, okay, is equal to id into e maximum minus e minimum. So e maximum minus e naught is equal to id into cot theta. Okay, so therefore id is written as e maximum minus e naught by cot theta. Okay, so substituting this id value with respect to this unity condition and zero condition for the loosest state and densest state, we'll be having like id is equal to e max minus e naught divided by e maximum condition minus e minimum condition. Okay, obviously if you take e naught is equal to e max, then what will become id? Id will be becoming 0. Why? Because if you substitute e naught here, e maximum, id will be 0. And next case, if you take e naught is equal to e minimum, okay, id will become 1. Why? Because if you substitute e naught as e minimum here, it will be cancelled and id value will be becoming 1. So we can say by these results as, for very dense gravelly sand, id sometimes come out to be greater or else than unity. Okay, so this would be only indicate that the natural packing and it does not permit us to be repeated or simulated. Okay, that is there, and here we'll see what are the representative values of density index for each and every typical unit with respect to weights also. Okay, we have a tabulation here. We'll see descriptive of the condition. Okay, so condition in the sense whether it is a loose state or densest state or very dense state or medium dense state. Okay, and for that cases, what is the density index percentage and what is the range with respect to weights. Okay, so you can write it as the range of unit weight, that is kilonewton per meter cube. Okay, so the first condition, if you take as loose condition, the density index will be less than 35. Okay, and the range will be less than 14. And next condition, if you see, if you take medium dense, okay, the density index will be in the range of from 35 to 65. Okay, so here it will be the range percentage 14 to 17. And the third condition is if it is dense state, the density index will be 65 to 85. Okay, and the percentage weight will be 17 to 20. And the last case is if it is very dense. Okay, the condition is very dense, then it will be greater than 85. Okay, and here the unit weight will be above 20. Okay, so this is the tabulation with respect to these are the representative values of density index and the typical units. Okay, so here depending upon the texture, sands with same void ratio may be displayed different abilities for densification. Okay, so what we can say here finally is the density index gives a better idea of the unit weight than the void ratio itself. Okay, so here the density index concept finds the applications in various states, in compaction of granular materials and in various soil vibration problems associated with, like you can take the density index is applicable in compaction of granular material. Okay, so in various problems like earthworks, pile driving, foundations of machinery, and vibrations which are transmitted to sandy soils by automobiles and trains. Vibrations in aspect of automobiles and trains, okay, etc. So by this density index values, which we have an idea in these all cases, so whether or not much undesirable consequences can be expected from engineering problems. Okay.